Welcome to join us. Here we will talk about cultural sensitivity in tourism and the conceptual framework. Introduction. Cultural sensitivity is a highly relevant concept in Arctic tourism. It can enhance our understandings, address contemporary challenges, and open up new possibilities for tourism. This conceptual framework is informed by collective efforts within Arctisen Project. Arctisen Project partnership and learning among Arctic tourism entrepreneurs, agencies, academics, including First Nation, Inuit and the Sami Indigenous peoples, and the World Indigenous Tourism Alliance, WINTA. This conceptual framework has been published in Annals of Tourism Research with title Cultural Sensitivity, Engaging Difference in Tourism. This presentation is based on an article by Arvid Viken, Emily Höckert and Brian Grimwood. Background. Local and indigenous livelihoods and environments in the Arctic are shaped by tourism development, climate change and colonial power relations. Need to address the legacies of cultural insensitivity, such as stereotyping, cultural assimilation, and appropriation. Our approach. Sensitivity as a subjective orientation toward others, otherness, and difference. This approach celebrates recognition, respect, and reciprocity in tourism encounters. Understanding cultures as relational and dynamic, not as vulnerable or fragile. According to the late Johnny Edmonds, cultural sensitivity boils down to respect. Our approach has been inspired especially by Emmanuel Levinas' relational ethics and Milton Bennett's phenomenologically informed model of intercultural sensitivity. Bennett says that cultural sensitivity is about skills and knowledge, but especially about self-reflectivity. In other words, it is important to reflect one's pre-assumptions, cultural norms, and values. Cultural sensitivity is an orientation that simultaneously shapes and is shaped by different kinds of narratives and encounters, including tourism products and services. This image illustrates our conceptual framework. These two circles illuminate the differences between ethnocentric and ethno-relative orientations toward otherness. The left circle presents culturally insensitive ethnocentric orientations. This orientation could also be described as insensitive, self-centered way of being that create categories between me and you, us and them. The right circle presents ethno-relative realm, in other words, a relational orientation that strives for openness, recognizing and respecting otherness and multiple others, and the dynamic nature of cultures. On one hand, cultural sensitivity can be seen as a prerequisite for responsible encounter. On the other hand, cultural sensitivity can be mobilized through tourism encounters that enhance respect, recognition and reciprocity among different actors. Examples of culturally sensitive orientations. Larrakia Declaration promotes the rights of indigenous communities in tourism development, underlining the importance of respect and recognition. In a similar vein, the Sami Parliament in Finland define mutual understanding and respect as the prerequisite to develop responsible Sami tourism. Storytelling within indigenous tourism setting enhance respect and recognition between storytellers and travelers. Moreover, making handicrafts can be a great way to learn about cultures. It is clear that respect, recognition and reciprocity are also central elements in responsible, culturally sensitive research. Challenges and future opportunities. Both culture and sensitivity are dynamic, contested, and relational concepts. Instead of nailing it, we welcome you for further discussion about cultural sensitivity in tourism. It is clear that the call for cultural sensitivity is not limited to indigenous cultures or Arctic places, but is relevant more broadly when different languages, rights, political organizations, influences, economic conditions and worldviews are encountered.